Well, Saturday morning is here. Hey, yeah, it's here. We welcome you to some of the finest radio you'll get your paws on here on a Saturday morning. Happy New Year to everybody. It is ToledoSportsNetwork.com. We got to change the name. We're three for all. Well, right now we are three. We've got Robert in-house looking suave and debonair. I got to say, Robert, I'm impressed with the new headphones.
Oh, these are the old ones.
Oh, those are the old ones? That's, oh, yeah. See, those are the ones I used to use, and I miss my headphones like that. I broke them. Very nice.
Oh, yeah, we saw that. Legendary.
Oh, no. They already broke before that. Yeah, they were already broke before that.
Oh, you just killed them the last time.
Yeah, they just a lot of years. A lot of years back when we were on 93 and oldies 93, and, you know, when we actually were working in radio and getting paid by the great Cumulus people. Now we pay them each and every Saturday morning from 8 to 9, maybe till 10 one of these days. We'll see. It is the new year. Of course, Jeff Manor right here at Pro Golf Fairways, and Nick and Jimmy's our home, our solid home.
Obviously, it's my home.
Yeah,
since I live here.
Yes. I noticed you have the cot in the back now.
Just working on the shower.
Uh-huh. And those weird blinking lights. I don't know what that's all about.
Which weird blinking lights?
Over top of your little bed over there, you know, with the mosquito guard over it and everything.
JMO. Oh. Certain things will never change.
Yes. That's the thing. We want it to be like that. It is. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, and we're definitely gonna talk about this incredible semifinals for the playoffs. That by last night they were talking. Wait a second. Let me sip my coffee here. Oh, I'm Mike Jameson, by the way. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to everybody out there. 2016.
Yes.
I thought I'd have myself a hoverboard and a hover car by now.
You got a hoverboard?
No, I said I thought I would have one, you know, a real one, not one with wheels on it.
Yeah, I know what you mean. They got them now, but... Yeah,
they're working on it.
Right.
You have to be on a magnetic strip, you know, what good is that?
Okay. Well, that's how it starts. First you have the magnetic strip, the next thing you know, it's titanium, and then we're all nuclear. So that's just the way it's going to be. The absolute, positively worst ratings for a college football... playoff quotation marks type game. It was that bad.
Well, you know, who it in the you know they, does people did anybody realize out there that Christmas? I mean, New Year's Eve is not a holiday. New Year's Day is a holiday, but New Year's Eve is not. And why are you putting bowl games on? I mean, how in the world can you sit there and watch bowl games when most people are just getting home from work and it's stupid and people have other plans for dinner and stuff and they warned they I mean everybody warned it, but these guys in this committee. They wanted to do that, you know. It's like
Ohio State, 1 o'clock. It was the most. It just.
Well,
it
I don't mind that. I mean, Ohio State. That's in stone. I mean, you know, the Rose Bowl is in stone, and all. I'm talking about. I don't worry about New Year's Day. I'm talking about New Year's Eve. I mean, Michigan.
Well, no, they were on New Year's Eve.
New Year's Eve, but I'm talking about no.
Oh no! Never mind.
You were on
I'm
New Year's
sorry,
Eve
what?
Day.
I sat for so long. My head.
They were on New Year's Eve day. This is and Michigan State was on New Year's Eve. And, God, guess it was a good thing I missed that one, huh?
Just incredible. The two semifinal games were just puke-a-thons. I mean, I literally ordered a pizza and didn't eat one piece of it. I fell asleep. They were that bad.
Bowl games yesterday were fun, at least.
Yeah. The Ohio State, congrats going out to Ohio State. I'm sure everybody's going to be talking about the targeting call.
It was unfortunate, but
we would quit being wimps.
It's a letter of the law.
Yeah,
but unfortunately, for a bowl game to have him removed on his last game was silly. And if you looked, it wasn't a violent move.
That's my point.
It wasn't like he was intensely trying to hurt him, but the letter of the law states... I really wish someone in the booth would have just said, okay, make it a personal foul, but let's not do a targeting. Just say, hey, you know.
Oh, they were SEC refs, like they were saying. They were SEC refs, and Ohio State is not one of the most well-liked teams anywhere.
Well, we'll be watching him on Sundays. Let's put it that way.
That's for sure. And then,
but you know, it was too bad to see. Then you know, Notre Dame loses one of their best defensive players within minutes of the game.
And now they were talking about it being a cheap shot. Did you?
No, he was on his own. He was even.
I was early in the game. I didn't.
He didn't get even hit by. He was making a move on his own and hurt himself.
Yeah.
It was an open. It was in the backfield. He made the move, and it was just his foot planted weird, and he went down. No one even hit him. But. And then hats off to Michigan. It was fun in here because we were packed yesterday during both those games were going on at the same time.
So you had them both on.
So Ohio State, Michigan, and it was actually, how do I say this, calm. Usually the Michigan fans are rooting against Ohio State and vice versa, you know, and you're just like, man, they actually, as a group.
They got along.
Got along.
Wow.
They're, you know, so.
It's amazing when good things like that happen.
And then, of course, there was actually quite a few people in here rooting for Notre Dame because the. Our Central Catholic boy that's playing for them as a quarterback. So their family usually comes in here. And so it was fun. Everybody was rooting for somebody. And I think the two best teams definitely won. But what happened to Iowa? Holy cow. I mean, if you would have blinked.
What a way to represent the Big Ten, eh?
What if you would have blinked and you looked up and you went, you'd have scratched your head and go, wait a minute, does that say 35-0 in the first couple minutes of the game?
It was 14-0 like in the first, 2 minutes?
Not even that. It was, the first play from scrimmage, bam,
gone.
Scored. McCaffrey just went crazy. Well, man, talking about an athlete there. Man, he is good.
But we got to see some pretty good football, and except if you're a Big Ten fan in not the upper echelons, because I consider the upper echelons Ohio State, period. but it was I just don't like the way this championship series crap thing is
gone. It should be starting on New Year's Day. I mean, this New Year's Eve doesn't make any sense.
Sure. I mean, that should be the last game. So that's like January 2nd. You got Saturday and Sunday, you know, this year at least.
Yeah, but I mean, I'm going to say it again. New Year's Day is a holiday. New Year's Eve is not. And people worked. And people are at work, and they're sitting there thinking they're going to get all these people watching the game. How?
Yeah.
And all they kept doing was saying, and the ESPN, it wasn't ESPN's fault, because ESPN told the committee they didn't want to have the New Year's Eve games. They said, you know, we should have the starting on New Year's Day and then go to the second if we have to. But
right.
But they didn't.
Or you got the third, too.
They didn't
That's
listen.
The
but, and that hopefully not too many people saw Sparty get banked. Man, that was ugly.
That was.
That's bad. Sorry to all Michigan State fans out there.
Another one of those, oh, my gosh, you blinked and all of a sudden this is not going to be good. What do you got, Rob?
Unfortunately, both Michigan State and Iowa were exposed. I'm sorry. Somebody was texting last night, if Iowa were playing in some other site, it would be different. And I'm sorry, but if you really get honest about it, it could have played in an Iowa cornfield, and Stanford would have closed down their mortgage on that farm. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's just no way. It could have played on the surface of the moon. But it also kind of makes a backwards argument for that 8-team playoff. Because rather than the snooze fest we saw, what would happen if you saw, let's see, number one Clemson against number eight Notre Dame, 2-7 and Alabama, Ohio
and
State.
Clemson almost lost to Notre Dame. That was
exactly.
A tight game.
And what is it? The 3-6 would have been Michigan State, Iowa. Okay, we'll pass on that one.
What was it again?
Michigan State, Iowa. If the rankings were still the same,
right.
And then 4-5. How about this one? Oklahoma, Stanford.
Wow.
You had two snooze fests, and this could have been.
Ohio State would have then played Alabama as the second.
Yeah,
game?
2-7. Ohio State, Alabama. There would have been at least three.
That would have been awesome.
Heavyweight bouts.
You know, it's interesting, but didn't Northwestern beat Stanford?
Yes, they did. First
and then Northwestern goes down 45-6 to Tennessee. It's like,
it's any given day.
It's like, which team showed up?
Any given day.
Which team showed up that day? That's all I know.
Well, I don't know about you guys. 2015 really sucked for me, but.
What are you talking about? You survived.
I survived.
That should suck would be if you weren't here.
Oh, no, that would.
Any year you can walk
You'd
away
be
from.
Asleep right now.
Any year you can walk away from is a good one.
That's true. That's
You're
true.
Still kicking, man. You're still
alive. Yeah, we made it through, and Dr. Todd finally got me to go to the hospital and figure out what the hell's wrong with me, and we still really don't know. I really believe it was that alien encounter I had.
And, okay.
Oh, here we go again.
Let's just say the 2015, we'll call that the resurrection of J-Mo.
Oh, is that it? There you go. Yeah, 2016 is the year of Mike. There's just no doubt. We as of Monday, will start working on Great Lakes Golf. Here's what we're going to do for golf show this year. Going into our 21st season of Great Lakes Golf, these courses just don't have any money. I mean, none of them do. And the money that they do have after what's happened the last couple of years, and it's not going to happen this year because this El Nino is going to bring it back to what it was back in the late 80s when it was hot, dry. It's going to be a hot, dry summer, and it's going to be an early summer, guaranteed. But we are going to get some – we're going to have like five major sponsors. What I want from you guys, if you're listening, is we're going to pick out our 20 courses that we're going to do, and I want you guys to pick them out. I want to get Arcadia Bluffs on there. Mm-hmm. I want to get, I know we'll be up at the Grand this year. We've got, some great courses. And, they're going to give us, foursomes to go golf these courses. So that's going to be part of our sponsorship. So, we need some nice big companies to come along on this so we can do it. We're there with 13. And if we can get enough companies, we're going to put it on Fox Sports. That way we're all about the Great Lakes then. So I'm excited about that, and kind of excited. Oh, next weekend I want a Riverview Yacht Club. My buddy Matt Zielinski is over there. They're having a big. They're going to be doing this every Sunday morning, pancake breakfast and everything for him over there. And I told him that. Over there in Point Place, Riverview Yacht Club. Go over there at 8 o'clock on Sunday mornings and eat pancakes.
Pancakes, huh?
Yes. So that's in a nutshell. We got basketball games this week. New Let's Fixer Up shows start this week. And other than that, I'm just waiting for some snow, baby.
It was snowing yesterday.
Yeah, but not...
Nothing major, but it was... I mean, I look out the windows and while people are playing golf, and it was coming down sideways, and I went, that's kind of nice.
Well, it's good for you because, number one, it's 20 degrees out and it's cold. So that makes things
cold and damp.
Yes, cold and damp.
It's been a little
like
dreary for the last
New
week.
Year's. Cold and damp.
Oh, boy.
But other than that,
I didn't even, I know that I'm getting old because I'm putting so many hours in here. And it was like, I don't know, it was like 11:30 the last time I looked at the clock. And I was, I had went home early enough, and just sitting there eating a pizza. Next thing you know, the wife comes over and nudges me and goes, we missed the ball drop. It's quarter after. I went, oh, great.
And you're
time to go to bed, get up and do this all over again. It's like, God, when did I get old, man?
Yeah, well, you cover it well. You cover it well.
Oh,
you do.
Geez.
You look pretty good. You look pretty good for a guy. What are you like? You're older than me.
Yes, I'm 53.
You're 50. No, I'm 53. Today's my birthday.
Yeah, I know what you. But you just caught me. You catch me, and then I lead ahead. Come June, I beat you again.
I see. if we get on the golf course, you'll beat me before that. But now that I'm feeling better.
Well, if you're in here tonight, I can,
You're going to help me out with this, the swing a little?
Not really. I just want you to have fun. It's your birthday, for God's sakes. Happy birthday, old man, by the way.
You'll watch my my daughter swing, and you'll tell her, why aren't you doing something with this? That's what you'll say.
Oh, why would I want to do that? Then she'll run away from it.
She doesn't do it anyway.
Tell her that she stinks at it and you don't want it. Don't ever play golf, then she'll want to do it.
I don't know.
Psychology. I'd have to do it with my daughter all the time. If I want her to do something, I'd tell her I don't want her to do it. It works.
I'm 100% with you on that. I'm 100%.
It works. If there's a boyfriend that she brings home you don't like, you just say, wow, he is great, man. Would you bring him around? And then she'll be going, God, this is not working. And
I would have to cut my arms off with my – I'd chew my arms off before I'd say that about the idiot she's dating.
Hey, come on. See? Now, you just – Now she's going, got it. I got it. Now I know what I can bug Dad with.
There is nothing on this earth that would get that. I told my daughter last night, she goes, Dad, what do you want for your birthday? I said, you know what I'd like? I'd like you to come in and do the radio show with us.
Getting someone up at that age?
I know.
Are you kidding me?
It ain't gonna happen. ain't going to happen.
That's not going to happen.
So, thank you, Haley. I'm sure she's out like a light somewhere right now. So,
the shooting simulators are shipping on Tuesday of this week, by the way.
Oh,
so
fantastic.
Hopefully by the time we go on air next week, we can actually have live demonstrations.
So we can shoot people right on the air.
We can
shoot
zombies and all types of things. Honey.
Truman should be back. The Trumanator, I think, is still down in Florida. Probably getting ready to hit the golf. He's on the driving range somewhere right now. Knowing Dave. He's on the driving range.
Before the sun gets up.
It's like Great Britain or Washington right now. It's just there's no sun. There's not going to be any sun. They said maybe later on today we'd see a spot of it. And I got the dumpster in my house. Hopefully I'll be getting rid of the dumpster today and the excitement unveils from there. But it's like, come on. But the great thing is you come in here over at doing the True Golf driving reality. You know what this thing needs? You need golf carts. So
we already got the best golf cart girls. They just don't have the cart.
Do. Yeah, this is true. You do. And I will probably be here about 8 o'clock. You know, if anybody wants to come over and we can put a foursome together.
Tonight?
Yeah. Yeah, text me at 419-514-1302. Just text me and say, yo. That's all I guess. Hey, Joe.
Yo, and, come over and play some golf.
Play some golf.
Got some people coming in this morning. It's been really good. I mean, the mornings and afternoons have been just packed. And then two nights in a row there, it was poor ridiculous that we're literally trying to push them out the door at 2 o'clock in the morning, and they don't want to go. And it's like, geez. I mean, they're making tea times at 11 and 12 o'clock at night, and you're like going, hmm.
Well, that's where I go, see? I mean, and then you shut off the alcohol, and they want to work that alcohol off.
Yeah, they were just having a blast. They were all having fun.
It is, and that's why I'm kind of excited about coming over tonight, even if I wind up here all by myself, because...
All by myself.
Eric Carmen, what a great song. What a great song.
No, there'll be people in here. They'll feel sorry. They'll play golf with you.
I know, they'll feel sorry. You were right the first time.
Josh will be here.
My anxiety level.
Your height level will be here.
You know, I am just like, I don't know what it is. I'm just, my testosterone levels must be at an all-time low or something. It's because I haven't got to play basketball. I think that's what it is. Robert's looking out the other door.
Yes, he's like, looking for my escape.
How do I get out of here fast?
Hey, we're over here at Nick and Jimmy's, by the way. We're going to have some breakfast this morning. And it's a new year, so they have new things going on this month. And we have a new sandwich of the month. I love this one. Betty Boop Wrap.
Oh.
You got to love that. Hey, Sarah came up with it, so you better love it.
All right, talk to me about it.
It's tomato basil wrap filled with a grilled chicken breast, feta cheese, romaine lettuce, red onion, tomato cucumber, hummus, served with a cucumber salad. Gotta love that. Sounds healthy, actually.
Yeah, that sounds like something I should
last
do.
Month it was definitely a great burger, but man, I don't think it was everything
like
you can think of.
2.5 pounds of some kind of cheese on it.
Oh, it had avocado. Oh. It had grilled onions and mushrooms. It had everything on it. I mean, it just fell off out of the bun. It was fun, but this one's a little healthy sounding. For the new year, I guess.
Well, we got a bunch more stuff coming up next week. It's a big week for us here because we're going to have guns here.
Is Mikey going to be back? hey, Mikey.
Well, Mikey was in town. Mikey just didn't
show
up.
Yeah, I can't believe he never called, texted.
He didn't even call me.
It's like, what's going on,
He
Mikey?
Was in town, and he just kind of dissed us off. But that's okay. You know, you're young. You know, you don't go back to your family. That's okay. I'm used to it. But we'll have guns here next week, and
that sounds so strange. It's for all your hunters and bow hunters, and actually they're bringing out the bow hunter software pretty soon here too. So
fantastic.
I know a lot of friends of mine, including my brother, that does that. So
we'll have phones by next week. The unit is in. It's sitting at UPS in Maumee, Ohio. It's been sitting here for 3 days. And I don't understand why it didn't get delivered on the 30th or the 31st.
Same reason why the blade wasn't delivered on Christmas Day yesterday. I went to the box this morning to get a blade, to look at the sports section. Yeah. No blade in the box. I'm like, well, maybe that might be a problem with your circulation if you can't get a paper.
Yeah, well, you probably just opened up a can of worms we just want the blade.
We just wanted it. We just wanted it. We wanted to be able to tell you we're reading this out of the blade this morning.
Yes.
I had to go print off all my scores off the computer.
And we'll be getting those scores here in just a couple of minutes. Got a couple of bills to pay here. And you're listening to ToledoSportsNetwork.com, 3-for-all, 106.5, The Ticket, ESPN. Is there anything else there?
I think we got it covered. At Pro Golf Fairways at Nick and Jimmy's.
There you go. We'll be right back. Pro Golf Academies and Technologies and Pro Golf Fairways. Toledo's number one stop for all your golf equipment needs. Instruction with licensed PGA and LPGA Tour instructor Jeff Menor. And the best golf simulators in the area. Located right next to Nick and Jimmy's on Monroe Street. Custom club fitting with name brand clubs and professional loft and lie capability. Now you can plan 18 holes on our Pro Golf Fairways with over 80 courses throughout the world with our state-of-the-art golf simulator systems. Call us at 419-205-6644. Safety Partners Limited has been providing excellence in safety since 1992, adding our Oregon, Ohio store in 2013. SPL Outfitters provides face, head, foot, hand, body, and hearing protection with great brands like Wolverine, Red Cap, Dickey, Wrangler Workwear, and many top safety brands. SPL also carries fire-resistant clothing, harnesses, high-vis apparel, boots, and boot care items. SPL is located in the Buffalo Wild Wings Plaza on Navarre Avenue. Mike Jameson and Jameson's Mobile Music is scheduling his 2015 bridal season. I would love to talk to you about your music and video needs for that special day. Now, we don't have 15 different sound systems going out every night, just one. And we concentrate on you and your special day. You will know your DJ. For over 25 years, Mike Jameson has been providing quality sound, lighting, and video for your special day. Call him today at 419-514-1302. Mike Jameson and Jameson's Mobile Music and Creative Video Imagery.
Stop struggling with the big box stores. Choose Gladio.
Gladio Home Center. A hardware store, yet so much more. Your home improvement answer store. Design your interior space. A professional and friendly smiling face. Everything you need for your home. And Gladio is locally owned. You'll be glad to know. Gladio, Gladio Home Center.
Taking care of your mom or dad as they get older may be more than you can handle on your own, but you don't have to do it alone. Call Always Best Care. We'll take care of your parents like family, and that's what makes us the best. All our caregivers are trained, insured, bonded, and dependable. So anytime you need us, whether it's a few hours a week or around the clock, we'll be there for you. We make the extra effort to make sure your loved one is comfortable and secure. We even provide on-call access to physicians anytime, day or night, together with your in-home care. We're dedicated to exceeding your expectations, always. Call Mark Riley of Always Best Care in the Toledo area for a free personalized care plan. 419-491-7114. That's Always Best Care. 419-491-7114. Or visit alwaysbestcare-nwohio.com.
On the job for you for over 100 years. You need a career. You need a future. Local 8 can help you make it happen. Join the men and women who build our community. Become a part of a proud tradition. Build your career. Build your future with the brothers and sisters of the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local Union 8. We're on the job for you.
We're on the job for you. We're the local IBEW.
It's Saturday morning. You got it. Tuned in to 106.5 The Ticket. ESPN at its best, and you're here with Mike, Rob, and it's Jeff Menor. We're at Pro Golf Fairways, place right next to Nick and Jimmy's on Monroe Street. Just an awesome place to come in and enjoy a round of golf, simulated golf, which is about the only kind of golf you're going to get to play today, that's for sure. And then go over and have one of the great entrees or breakfast. I got to tell you, I've changed up the Egg Wars breakfast a little bit.
You did. You went for cheese over it.
I put a little cheese on that thing, and then I get that that splat of death, better known as a sausage burger or sausage, which is just tremendous. It's just awesome. Little A1 on the side, and bada boom, bada bing.
I was doing the kielbasa over the holidays.
Really?
On the side, yeah. I love their kielbasa.
See, kielbasa, I think we had this talk.
Yeah,
there's
we did.
There's kielbasa and kielbasa.
Yep.
I had a lot of kielbasa over the holidays. And but not a lot of kielbasa. So now it's time to throw in some kielbasa in there.
I was talking to my wife last night, and I said, you know what time of year
felony?
This is? Yeah, felony.
Hi, felony.
It's
we love
pastrami
you.
Time. I love going to the deli, getting pastrami's cut, sliced, putting that on rye bread.
They got that over at Big Apple Deli.
Yeah, I know, but I have to drive all the way out there.
You just do it.
I'm looking forward to that because I can bring it in here, make my sandwiches, and heat them up in a microwave now.
Was that your birthday, your Christmas present?
That was my Christmas present.
Aw. You have such a good wife. You really do. I mean, you have the total package. How'd you do that?
It's smoke and mirrors. It's smoke and mirrors, baby.
I mean, we know you. We see you.
I live here all day long. Is that your point?
We're like your second wife.
I see.
And
you
Dave
guys.
Truman is like that mean kid, like your firstborn kid. Dave
no,
Truman.
he's like that kid on Home Alone that ate the cheese pizza. And left nothing around. What was his name? Bud. Bud. Thanks a lot, Bud.
We miss him. I know he's having a good time down in Florida right now, and then we miss him. All right, we don't miss you that much. So.
And I was going to say, come on, man.
Because I know he's going to text
Mikey would
us.
Say, come on, we can never miss him. Are you kidding me?
And Mikey, I think, is still in town. I haven't heard from him. I figured I'd hear from him. I figured I'd hear, happy birthday, Mikey, or something.
Yeah, I figured he'd come in here because, you know,
but now
he used
that he's
to
an
hang
Asheville
out.
Guy.
But he'd hang out. He was hanging out here at Nick and Jimmy's all the time. I don't know why he wouldn't come in here.
I think he's, you know, he's singing, you know, country sad songs now. And probably got himself a little woman down there now.
There's plenty of them down there, I'll tell you that.
And so we're not going to hear from Mikey anymore. It's just sad. It's sad. It's just sad. And next week we'll have phones, so he'll be able to call in.
We hope so, as long as it leaves UPS sometime this week.
Well, the one thing we got to do is that little switch button that's on there. We got to take care of that little. So I got this nice little box now that I'm going to put that thing right in there. So.
Did you hear that? He's going to take care of his equipment. Did you hear that?
Oh, don't tell me
that. Another sign of the oncoming apocalypse. But, we really haven't given Mr. J the formal congratulations, happy birthday.
Oh.
It's like, yes, happy birthday.
You
kind of brush past it, but yeah. I don't think the listeners really
I'm not really good at holidays anymore. I should be joyous.
When was your birthday a holiday?
Oh, true.
I mean, we can petition to have it made a holiday.
Robert's going to put a tear in my eye somewhere. I just know it. He's going to make me cry. I don't want to cry today.
Oh, my God.
No, I would just say things like,
I really, really.
Here we go.
I need to get another cup of coffee.
Do we need music for this?
Oh, man. Speaking of, we have some bowl games today starting at noon. I think Penn State, who are they playing?
I want to hear what Robert has to say. This could be interesting.
Oh, I don't want to hear you cry, though, man.
Oh, I won't cry.
No, trust me. You won't be crying because, as we've said before, Chuck Norris sleeps with the lights on simply because this man exists.
Oh.
Come to think of it, he keeps Chuck up at night.
What?
He once led He once led Tibetan monks in a Gregorian chant at the Wailing Wall.
Oh, I have. Yeah, that's me.
He is the man Miguel Angel Jimenez aspires to be.
Yeah.
The seasons change at his suggestion.
Yes.
When he turns on his iPhone, Siri asks him for information.
Ooh, Siri and I are now dating.
If he misspells your name, you're under obligation to change it.
Wow.
He thinks 24/7, so you don't have to.
Whoa.
You're welcome. He is the most interesting man in Toledo sports media. Asterisk. And happy birthday.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you. I appreciate that. I feel all of 25 right now. Actually, I got to tell you, I feel young and I'm really excited. This is like my first year in 5 years because whatever this big old growth or tumor or whatever the hell thing in my lung is, it's whatever it is, they got it under control. You know what I mean?
Drano.
That's exactly. Well, it's not cancer, thank goodness.
Drano.
I got to be thankful that it's not what it is. I think what it is, I swallowed one of them little washcloths, and it got caught up in there, and that's what it is. It's a big old washcloth. But anyways, I feel so young. I mean, Brad Morrison, one of my best buds over there at Maumee Bay Turf, he's got this pole barn in his backyard that he bought the floor from like the 2002 or 2003 college down in Atlanta, you know, the floor.
The floor. He bought the floor?
Yeah. And
the portable floor?
Yeah, he actually built He built a pole barn, turned it into a basketball thing, and it's the coolest place around. And we go over there and play once a week, and, you know, it's just a bunch of us old farts, and then the young farts come in and play against us. We don't lose a lot of games. Yeah, I guess we do. But I can't thank Brad enough, and I know Brad listens every morning, and because he works like we do. He works 24 hours a day. He puts the AstroTurf, but it's not AstroTurf, in it, all the big football fields.
Artificial.
The artificial.
Field turf?
Field turf. Yes, and
with all the little rubber little beads and stuff.
Yep, mm-hmm. And they, I go out and film for him, and he just did Defiance High School, and it's breathtaking. Well, if you've been over to Whitmer, and you got to see Whitmer's field, I mean, they did Whitmer's field. It's breathtaking how beautiful it looks. Mm-hmm. And
isn't that when they put down the logo from Pennsylvania? The Panther, remember? They got called up and said, "You got to remove that symbol from your feet. We got a patent on
it." That was a long time ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, but you know, that's just why alumni. They do silly things like that.
That was a long time. You know, they did that this summer. And love them to death. I got some of the best friends in the world, and just being able to get out with these guys and play a little basketball. And I suck. I'll be the first one in a minute. Anybody who's ever played basketball against me realizes one thing. I'm just this big piece of blob that causes trouble in the middle, and I'll score 8 points every 6 weeks. I'm not a scorer. I'm not going to take that chance now because I'm too old. I'm 53 now, and I don't want to be the guy with broken ankles and broken – but I want to be out there running, you know, playing, doing my job. Everybody knows I'm not a scorer. I'm not a scorer.
I see that in golf, too.
I mean, with apologies to Muriel Spark, this is the prime of Mike Jameson.
The prime?
Yeah.
You're right.
Yeah, this is prime time. You are prime time.
Well, no, I'm excited because, number one, we'll be coming out tonight. We're going to see just how well I can swing a club. I know there's not a lot of upper body strength, but it's going to be a whole different beast. And
he's going to use the force, ladies and gentlemen. Look out. He's bringing the force.
Having wind instead of just being able to break wind is going to be.
Break wind. Oh, man. I don't want that.
I'm just saying. It ain't about breaking wind anymore. It's about having wind. And I feel good.
Where are we going with this show this morning?
Yes. But I'm excited about that. And Dr. Leslie, Todd Leslie, got me in and got me. He knew something was wrong.
All right. Well,
so I'm excited
we're looking
about
forward
that.
To 2016, so we don't have to worry about him talking about his twin brother that was never born.
He's gone.
Drano.
He'll be gone. And then I got to let you know, my dog Marley last night, first night he's done this in the world, jumped up in bed, and we had a nice spooning, me and my 100-pound, my 80-pound Labrador. Hey. So
where's the music? Cue the music.
We gotta change this real. Could you give me the bowl games that are coming up here?
Oh my God! Yes,
today. I know it's new. Penn State playing who?
I had to do something. Yeah,
who's
I had
Penn
to do
State
something.
Playing?
So. Yeah, Penn State and Georgia are at 12. Let's see, we have Kansas State and Arkansas at 3:20.
Let you know, I'm making the dip for that one.
Okay. And then we have the last two ranked teams. TCU and Oregon it's Oregon, right?
Oregon.
Okay, it's Oregon here, it's Oregon there. Because Oregon. I grew up underneath Oregon.
See. Yeah,
and so
you lived in California.
Yeah, and I came out here and it Oregon. Yes. What the heck is that?
Oregon.
Okay, but yeah, Oregon.
Now, wait a second. You passed over TCU, didn't
the Horned Frogs. The quarterback.
The quarterback got arrested.
He decided to go to Pat O'Brien's, which is one of my favorite places down in New Orleans, I have to admit, with the dueling pianos and stuff. But you got to stay away from the Hurricanes, man, because first of all, he was in bed check for curfew at midnight, and then all of a sudden he's back out at 2:00 in the morning and he's beating up cops.
He took a page from Kenny Stabler's playbook when he was down there with the Raiders way back when.
So he's going to, miss the first play of the game, and then he'll play the rest of the game, right?
No, he's been sent home. He's been sent packing.
Wow.
And then the last game is West Virginia and Arizona State. Yum, yum. Hmm. At 10:15.
That'll be when we start making the Sundays. Oh, no, I'll be here.
You'll be
I should be
golf.
Here.
You'll be playing golf.
Yes.
Or something like that.
Yeah.
Can't you wait so you can play golf, and then you, if you suck at it, you can start shooting people?
Boy, would that not be reality for me, I'll tell you.
Yeah, we've seen clubs go sideways. We've seen all sorts of things.
Mayhem, you know, chaos. My whole goal was last year, because once again I didn't get to play, and now I know why, but was to mess Dave Truman's game up. That was my goal. And then when we'd play together, mm-hmm. you know, Dave and I, we play pretty good golf together.
Go for loftier aims. I really think what would really be something, if you wanted to do this on the show,
yes.
is have Jeff in a segment called Bringing Up Mikey, where you get your handicap at the beginning.
Okay.
And then you have all of these sessions where Jeff gives you lessons. And those are lessons that will help everybody else.
Oh, okay.
And then we take your temperature, say, in June, a temperature in September, to see how your handicap has gone down. I don't know. I think this would be compelling because you're in shape now.
I'm not in shape, but I feel better.
Well, you're
oh, by the way, next week, we're going to have Dare Carpenter in here next week.
Oh.
Yeah. I was going to try and get her in here today, but... She Dare had to stop working with me. Obviously, mm-hmm.
She tried to kill you.
Yeah. I never put two and two together.
You didn't see Colonel Mustard in the study with the yoga suit. Okay, fine.
She even said we were talking over Christmas at A+ Home Improvement's, one of our big sponsors for Let's Fix Her Up, and I do their Christmas party mm-hmm. at the Toledo Club every year. And Dare and I always wind up sitting down just shooting the poop for a while about things. And she goes, you know, those last few times I was there, you just had this weird look in your eye. And it kind of scared
death.
Me.
Death.
Yeah.
It's that glow that Dick Sargent saw in the Twilight Zone episode when he saw the people were going to die. Yeah.
His gray color. His gray skin color.
Exactly.
Yellow in the whites of the eyes.
You could peel me like a banana.
Cool. It was kind of an indication. He was standing there, you're going, man. You look like crap.
Yeah. And then I got some color back, and I feel good. So I'm going to...
They drained 30 pounds off of you.
I want Dare to come in, because this is the time when you want to, maybe take some classes, maybe start getting yourself ready for golf or whatever. You know,
New Year's resolutions are kicking in.
Exactly. And just, you know, for me, I'm lifting weights now. I got to get my wind back, which I've got... more wind than I've ever had in the last 5 years.
Yeah,
and not that kind of wind.
All I got to do is sit next to him in a radio show. Yeah. He'll tell you all types of wind you're talking about, man.
But it's just getting the turning and stuff done. Because at 53, you know, you're 53. Robert, 55. You're young. You're 55.
No, 54 going on 55.
You're older than us?
Yeah, I've been telling you that.
Good? Wow, what the heck? You know what it is? It's those foods that you... Hey, Robert Robinson, you wanna like him on Facebook, because he puts all of these dishes out that he cooks. And when we put Dine Out Toledo back on, we're going to have Robert doing some cooking.
Well, I had a catering business off in California, and so it kind of went fallow, but then my wife turned me on to Blue Apron, and she's an excellent cook as well. And the thing is, if I had met her in California, we wouldn't be having this conversation, because I'd have a restaurant over there someplace, because she is that good, and she would have been able to keep me propped up. But,
maybe you need to have a restaurant here in Toledo.
Oh, no. Too far down the road.
He doesn't want to work.
Yeah, that's true. I don't
We're coasting.
He doesn't want to be like me, working 12-hour days and 18-hour days. That's no fun.
We're going down that down slope. We're testing our brakes to make sure that they still hold.
Yes, yes, yes. Well...
Tapping your brakes before you come to the toll booth.
Couple more commercials here, and we're going to regroup. We're going to regroup here. It's going to be exciting. We'll have Darren next week, and hopefully. You know, we've talked about it.
Well, just go get her. Go to her house. Say, Dare.
Well, no, her Dare. And Glenn, her husband is like the coolest dude, and we're going to have him on our Let's Fix Her Up show, because he's like a – good-looking contracting kind of guy.
Hunky contractor to bring in the women.
Exactly, because obviously I haven't. Even though I get a lot of people who see me at Kroger's, hey, you're that guy.
Yeah,
hey,
you're that guy with that thing.
Yeah, yeah. Can you come over and put a new kitchen in my house for free? it doesn't work like that. But maybe we can help you out. Gladio. We'll get Ronnie Gladio. And there's another guy. We have Ronnie Gladio on here, too. So, and Jeff Marin, the whole group. You know, all these guys should be coming in here to golf tonight.
Yeah, where in the heck are they all at?
Yeah, Marin probably, he's probably at a volleyball tournament in Australia or something, because his daughter is just phenomenal. And they'll, but maybe I can get him in here. I don't know. Hey, we've got more coming up for you here, and we're going to talk NFL just a little bit today and go from there. This is ToledoSportsNetwork.com and 106.5 The Ticket. ESPN at its best.
There you go. Pub 51 is just a great neighborhood bar and grill. They're about as close to being all things to all people as I've seen. They have a miniature bowling league, and they take that pretty darn seriously. Oh, and a dart ball league, and a cornhole league, and a pool league. They have a lot of leagues. Pub 51 has a big outdoor patio, too. Their pizza and food are reasonably priced, too. Give Pub 51 a try. They're on Woodville Road, just a half mile east of the Woodville Mall.
The Union Plumbers, Steam Fitters, and HVACR Service Mechanics of UA Local 50 build the powerhouses that generate your electricity, install and service your heating and air conditioning systems, and install the plumbing systems that protect the health of this nation. Everywhere there's a building being built, retrofitted, or maintained, members of UA Local 50 are on the job with skills and the latest sustainable building practices. To do the job right, UA Local 50 plumbers, steam fitters, and service mechanics. Building America's future.
The Big Apple Deli has all the food for your next party or get-together. The best subs, salads, soups, pasta, party trays, and great, great lunch and dinner specials. The Big Apple Deli, 2118 Woodville Road, has got you ready for all your party needs or just stop out for a great, great lunch.
Hello?
Hi, Becky. This is Harold. I was wondering if maybe you wanted to go out with me.
Harold, I told you 1,000 times. I never want to go out with you.
No. Really, you said you never wanted to be seen with me.
So why are you asking me out again?
Yesterday, I went to TAS Electronics and had my windows tinted, so now you don't have to be seen with me.
Well, in that case, you can pick me up at 8.
Get your windows professionally tinted today. Any two windows, any percentage for just $69, and that includes a lifetime guarantee. TAS Electronics, 3 superstores and at TAS1.com.
No Christmas lights. No. 106.5 ESPN, The Ticket. You're listening to Mike, Mr. Roberts, and Mr. Jeff here with the three for all.
And we just had a confession that Mike was putting his lights up today.
No. Here's the
Christmas lights.
No. You're probably right, though. That's the way I would do it. As much as I love Christmas, I'm telling you. Chestnuts roasting by my...
Never mind. No, you're a mean one, Mr. Grinch.
Yeah. Anyways, we're putting lighting... I'm putting new LED lighting up in my garage. I got HAI, brought a dumpster over, and... Hey, you know what? They're not a sponsor, but I'm going to tell you, one of these days I'm going to get them for our Let's Fix Her Up show. But I do want to get a shout-out to them, HAI.
Incorporated?
Yes. They, I know they're in Rossford. I think their number is 666-6000, something like that. It's all sixes. I know that. So.
That's a little evil.
You know, they're just really, real good people. And this is the freebie. I paid for my dumpster, and they – You know, I got a nice dumpster, good sized dumpster for what we needed, and I'm going to be able. I won't ever be able to park a car in my garage, but at least I'm going to move things around a little bit here and make things happen. That's my excitement for the day. So, but these new LED lights, and they've got them that they last forever.
That's what we're using in here. We're switching everything over.
Well,
to
these are like this is strip lighting for like in a garage and stuff like where you put fluorescent bulbs in. Right.
But
this is one big strip.
Those are strips. Those are strips with, you know, lights connected to.
Oh
the strips.
No, yeah, I understand those too. But I'm talking about the ones you know with the big fluorescent bulbs and all of that. And these things just last like.
And they save a lot of energy.
That's I got LED everywhere.
That's where we're switching over LED. Our outside lighting we did is our strips out by the windows are LED. So.
Well, that's just there's your Let's Fix Her Up
tip of the day.
You know, we need to get a quick tip girl. We used to have some of the most beautiful girls that just did quick tips on Let's Fix Her Up going into our 21st season of Let's Fix Her Up. Can you believe
everything's
that?
Going in like in the 20th season.
I know.
Not bad.
Wow. Means I'm going to die here one of these days.
Hey, no.
Getting
no.
old.
No, the Grim Reaper stared you in the eye last year, and he blinked.
Yeah, he did. He did. He took off. He took off.
Because he's the most important man in news
most
media.
Most interesting man in sports media.
No, asterisk.
He told me important.
Impotent.
Hey, so we got some NFL coming up.
Before you go there, let me do this. The first time the word impotent or important, I gotta tell you a little story about this, okay? Jay Richards, who is one of my dearest friends in radio, I was a salesman at 105 back in the early 90s, and I had convinced Jay Richards that I'd be a good guy to put on radio. Never been on radio before, never did it, never nothing. So 1470, which we've been on, at that point was called Classic Country 1470. So they put me on. And matter of fact, Don King, who did his shows for Whitmer and everything, I produced his shows. And so I had my little beal on 1470 Classic Country. So I played a lot of Vern Gotson on Classic Country. Well, anyways, long story short, they would give us these cards to read, these PSA cards to read, public service announcement. Yeah. And one of the public service announcements was, and I wish I could find it, because it was to talk about that there are over 100,000 men out there that are impotent.
They're not important. They're impotent.
So what did I say? I didn't say important. I said there are 100,000 men out there with impotence. That was I was impotence, and I kept reading it, and I kept reading it like that, and that was my it was impotent, but it's impotence. I said they was very impotence kind of guys. Anyway, NFL.
Wow, that was a lead into NFL.
Yeah. Hey, we're funking you up, man.
It's amazing that we're in the 17th week, and we actually have games that are deciding a lot of things tomorrow.
Well,
I mean, we've got Green Bay and Minnesota. My Packers have been really struggling.
I got to tell you.
Horribly struggling. They have no poor offensive line is not there.
Now, if they lose, if Minnesota wins, which I think is probably going to happen, they still have a chance to get in, though.
Oh, they got they're in a wild card. They got a wild card automatically, except the fact that they really do need to win because they don't.
Terrible.
See, right now they don't have any
terrible
offense whatsoever. And New England's going down to Miami in play, and that would if they need to win to. I think that's to get them a home field and bye, right?
I believe.
I think
so.
They need that for the home field advantage.
I just want Bengals, Miami's got to win that one.
And the Bengals are playing Baltimore, I believe, right?
Yep.
And that's another – I mean, that's how many games – these are a lot of good games that need to be won by individual teams.
And the Bengals
– they looked so good last game. It just came out on the short end of the stick. And unfortunately, I'm kind of pulling. It's Ohio team, I'm kind of pulling for
them. Right. Well, they –
And I don't like Baltimore at all.
Baltimore's been terrible all year, and then all of a sudden comes up with these fluke wins, So it's – that could be an interesting – you're right. There's some actual pretty good games. And – Manziel's not playing for the Browns. He's done.
No.
Do you really think he'll
concussion
be
concussion protocol?
Yeah.
They
took an X-ray, found nothing up there, but yeah. But
Trump.
The music's still banging off his the walls of his.
But the Steelers are the ones that are currently holding the rosary because now they're on the outside looking in because they lost to the Ravens. So they have to.
What happened there? I mean, Big Ben and Steelers were looking so unbeatable. I mean, they look so good. And I'm thinking they were going to go into this big game and just dominate. And they got they got it handed to them last week.
They were the Week 16 team that nobody wanted to face in the playoffs. And then they get pants. Now, they have to hope that the Jets lose to the Bills. And they have
that's
to take
another
care of
big game.
I hate the Jets.
And that's another big game. Because,
God, are they playing good.
If they win and my running back Chris Ivory goes crazy, they could – I mean, it's just – I've never seen – it's kind of fun because I haven't seen it like this. Usually they're sitting players out because they've already got, home field and buys all set up and they're trying to keep them from getting hurt. And the starters are all playing. I mean, there's a lot of good teams, which is good for me in fantasy because – at least I prevent from one more loss. I can't win anything. I've looked at our list, and it's just
you're out of it.
I can't even get into third place.
And you're not yelling about it. That's
no,
the thing because
last year,
normally
last year, last
when you're
year
playing
I was
for third place.
Last
you're the
year I was
guy
upset.
Ever put on this
last
earth.
Year I was upset last year because I'm leading. I pretty much can win the second half and had a chance to win overall. And I had, it was last year, of course, it was a different story, but I had Andrew Luck in and a couple receivers from, and they didn't play them the last two games. And so I got no points, and I ended up slipping out of the money. And I'm like, that's just not fair. This year, my guys have to play. I got Tom Brady, and, of course, he's playing, but, I got points. That's what's strange. If you look at win-loss, points, four. I mean, I've got all the points in the world, but I've lost these. I've got like two ties, and I've got I've lost like by point here, point there, and it's like it doesn't do you any good. It's still a loss, so it's just preventing me to lose another game.
Truman just texted us to let us know that he's immune. I don't know what that means.
He's immune to what? He's down golfing in Florida.
He's immune.
Yeah, he's down. He's immune. He doesn't have. Infinite. Thank God. Well, now,
steering this back onto the tracks, there are a couple of other key games, Texans and Jaguars, and let's see, Titans and Colts, because believe it or not, the Colts are 7-8, but they still have a shot.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah. Nope. Yeah. That division's really kind of screwy.
The Steelers.
There could be a one loss or somebody with a losing record that could. Oh, my.
Yes, and there's an actual chance there could be a winning team that's. That big one, like what, 11? Who is it could actually get bumped out?
If the Jets lose and the Steelers win, the Jets would be 10-6 and out of the playoffs. If the Steelers had won last week and both teams won, the Jets would be 11-5 and out of the playoffs. With a team like the Colts or the...
It's just the way it works.
Yeah,
people.
The Colts or the Texans could be 8-8 and in.
Yeah, it's kind of goofy, but that's the way it works.
Well, just so we do it and we talk a little bit about it, the Ohio State game yesterday. Wonderful game. Congratulations going out. The Bosa incident, which just blew up. I mean, Facebook went. I literally shut my phone off because I don't know how to shut off those. It was pa-ding, 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 pa-ding. It just wouldn't stop.
You put it in the freezer.
Really?
Yeah. That's
you know I'll try that. That's as scary, yeah.
Just make sure you defrost it in rice.
You guys are big on football and what's going on and everything. Where is this coming with this helmet to helmet thing?
Well, no. It's not. That's a misconception. It doesn't matter. As long as you lead with the crown of the helmet to any place on the body, you could be going at a shoelaces. If you lead with your crown, it's called targeting.
Okay.
They're trying to prevent head injuries and neck injuries because too many people have been leading with their heads. And they've actually the guys that have been doing the tackling are getting hurt more than the guy that's on the receiving end. Unfortunately, if you're looking at the game, it's going as high speed as it was.
Yeah.
He moved into him. It could have been just as easy as his right shoulder hitting him in the chest, except the quarterback's is moving from a right to left fast, and it ends up being And it wasn't malicious. I've seen malicious targeting that you go, man, what just happened to Odell Beckham a week or two ago.
Now
there's a definition of total targeting
right
there. But I understand where people are upset. But the letter of the law states if you lead with the crown of the helmet, but – there should have been a little discretion there. They could have said, you could have said that it was accidental lead of the crown of the helmet and still could have kept it a personal foul and just let him play the game. And I understand, but, I guess, that's their decision. Mm-hmm. But in the letter of the law, that was considered targeting because he led with the crown of the helmet.
Robert?
Agreed, because ironically, that was the first play that I saw. I was actually walking in as my wife was watching, and I saw Joey Bosa with his head down. I said, no, because I knew it was going to happen even before they threw the bloody flag, even before there was an interception, because you could see it. And that's the way they call it. So if they were consistent, and they have to be consistent based on the rule that's in play. Now, maybe this causes them to revisit it and say, okay, there is some discretion with the replay official to say, okay, if he stumbled, and it looked like he stumbled into him.
Yeah, it almost looked like he got pushed and stumbled. Mm-hmm. And they do have that ability. It's still up to that. It's still up to the booth to do it, though,
as,
to recall.
As somebody who played a little football, I distinctly remember all of my, and I could be wrong, it's been a while, But didn't they always tell you, like, when you're going in,
yes,
to put your head down?
Oh, no. This is what the hardest thing.
Oh, no,
this is the hardest thing.
Snap your neck.
Right. But, and the thing is that that's what the hardest thing is for these players that have been playing in the era where they changed this rule. Yeah. Because they have been taught this. And NFL players will talk about it. The college players, they're trying to start it so that they no longer do this in the junior levels and stuff, which they should. But it is very hard when you've been taught this is what you do all your, you know, the whole time you've been playing from, you know, not hole all the way up to high school to college ball. That's what they taught you, and it's very hard to break. But it was, I say, it could have very easy. They could have said a personal foul, but it wasn't targeting because it wasn't malicious at all.
It's I didn't get it. But like you said.
Because, you know, back when UT was in that that game, they reversed the call.
Right.
They said it was targeting. When they went back, he wasn't targeting. They reversed it. They kept it a personal foul, but they reversed the targeting. But, you know, it's just the way it is. Unfortunately, he lost his last game.
Yep. Folks, don't forget ToledoSportsNetwork.com. 106.5's got some great bowl games for you this weekend, so check them out. Of course,
here at Pro Golf Fairways and Nick and Jimmy's, we got all types of things to offer you here for all the games and all the bowl games and all the other restaurants and that Nick and Jimmy's has, Village Inn, Basin Street, Cocoa House. So visit them all.
That's a good thing. Robert, once again, thank you. Of course, the Aurora House. We got some good things coming up for 2016, don't we?
Yep, the 30th anniversary. But also remember that Toledo Sports Network is worldwide.
Yes.
On the web. And one of Mike's resolutions is to get all of his shows up on
the web. This will be on today. It will, definitely. It will be on today. I promise. Tonight we've got some basketball. We're looking back at some of our games on CW13 starting at 8 o'clock tonight. Let's Fix Her Up, our home improvement show, will be on 9 o'clock tomorrow. And we have got some incredible surprises coming up for you here in 2016. Guys, thanks for sticking around.
Yep. Go to ProGolfFairways.com and hit them straight.
Yeah, that's for Dave Truman. Dave, we love you. Miss you. Get your butt back here.